What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about top four ways to enable memory integrity on Windows. So let's get right into it. All right, number one in my list is the manual process, which is super simple. So to do this, we need to get into your Windows 11 or Windows 10 box. We're going to click on Start, and we're going to start typing Core Isolation. We're going to click on Core Isolation to open it up, and there goes the option to basically turn it on. So you're going to slide it to your right to turn it on. You're going to get the user account control. Click on Yes. Once you click on Yes, on the lower right-hand side, you're going to get a notification that you need to restart your machine. So click on Restart. You're going to get another user account control dialog box. Click on Yes, and it will start restarting. Now, number two in my list is Intune, creating an Intune policy. So within your Microsoft 365 Admin Center, on your left-hand side, we are going to click on Show All. Once you click on Show All, we are going to locate and click on Endpoint Manager. Now, once that loads up, on your left-hand side, we are going to click on Devices. And underneath By Platform, we are going to click on Windows. Once this loads up, we're going to go into the Configuration Profile section. We're going to click on Create. We're going to pick New Policy. You're going to get a side menu. We're going to click on the first drop-down menu, and we're going to pick Windows 10 and later. Now for the profile type, click on the drop-down menu, and we're going to pick Settings Catalog. Click on Create. Give your profile a name. This is what I provided. We are going to click Next here. For the configuration settings, we are going to click on Add Settings, and we're going to type in the following: Hypervisor Enforce Code. Hit Enter or click on Search. We're going to select virtualization-based technology, and it's going to give you an option right below. We're going to check off Hypervisor Enforce Code Integrity. We're going to close our side menu, and we're going to configure our integrity. So click on the drop-down menu, and we're going to pick the second option, Enable with UEFI Lock. Awesome. Let's click on Next. For tags, I typically do not use tags within my profiles, so I'm going to click Next here. For assignments, I am going to click on Add Groups, and I'm going to select my group. Once I'm done selecting my group, I'm going to click on Select. I'm going to click on Next. A nice little review. I'm going to click on Create. And on the upper right-hand side, you're going to see a notification that the policy was created. And if you give it some time or refresh the page, you should see the new policy there. Now, number three is GPO, Group Policy Object. So open up your management console. From here, we're going to select our Group Policy Object. I'm going to right-click on that folder, and I'm going to select New. I'm going to provide my GPO a name, and this is what I gave it. Computer, because it's actually attacking the computer configuration node, and I'm going to click OK. Select our GPO. We're going to right-click on it, and we are going to click on Edit. Now, within our GPO, we are going to select the computer configuration node. We're going to open up policies. We're going to open up administrative templates. Within administrative templates, we're going to open up systems, and within systems, we are going to locate device guard. Now, the one that we want to configure would be turn on virtualization-based security. So we're going to double-click on that. We're going to enable it. And what we need to configure would be the second option, which is the virtualization-based protection of code integrity. So click on the drop-down menu and select your option. Now, the option that we're going to pick would be the second one, which would be Enable with UEFI Lock. We're going to apply it. We are going to OK it, and you're done. Well, not really done. You basically made the modifications and made the GPO. Now, the only thing that you need to do is apply that GPO to a specific OU, and then you're good to go. Now, the last one in my list is all about the registry. There is a registry hack that you are able to make modifications to enable this feature. Now, to do that, this is how it looks when the registry is not applied. So we're going to right-click on the Start menu. We're going to type in Reg Edit. We're going to click OK. Most likely, your machine prompts you for your user account control. Just click on Yes. Now, from here, we're going to go inside the HKEY local machine. Within the HKEY local machine, we're going to double click and open up the systems folder. Within here, we're going to locate the current control set, and we're going to open up control. Within the control, we're going to locate and open up the device guard. Now, within the device guard, we're going to select scenarios. And within scenarios, we're going to right click on that folder and we're going to pick new. And we're actually going to create a new key. Now, the key name is going to be the following. The way that you see it is the way that we need to type it in. And we're going to right click on that folder, click on new, and we're going to create a new DWORD 32-bit value within that key. Now, that new D word, this is what we're going to call it, enabled. Super simple. We're going to actually double click on it because by default it is set to zero, but we need to change it to one because zero is actually off. One actually enables it. We're going to okay that and restart your machine. Once you restart your machine, what you could do is click on start and locate core isolation and then open that up. You should see this. The setting is managed by your administrator. This is what you get if you apply the registry key. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.